Hi friends, in this video, let's talk about one important function in the SQL Server 2016. This is the one which helps us to concatenate the strings easily in the SQL Server. But ideally, if you see in the earlier version, we used to do a concatenate operator like plus and so on. But starting from 2016, so we can directly use concat operator or built-in function to concatenate the strings. So let me explain you practically in the SQL Server 2016. So let me go to the SQL Server 2016. So this is a place where I am going to show you practically how to work with a SQL functions. So first let me show you with a basic select statement. Select concat of, if you really see that expression, comma, expression and so on. So let me put some strings here. This is my, or let me put separately, this space end semicolon comma is space end semicolon comma start semicolon my space end semicolon comma, let me put as first space comma start semicolon example. This is my first example. So let me end it and run this. So if you see here, if you understand very clearly, I am planning to concatenate 5 strings here. I am not using any of the plus operator here. I am simply using built-in system SQL function. So let me execute and show you the output. If you see the output here, I'll get a single statement saying that this is my first example. The one advantage of going with concatenate is in the middle here, we autocoded the strings here easily. We can identify that. But in the real world, when you are working in any of the project there, while concatenating, you may need to handle some nulls as well. But if you go with a concatenate or if you go with a concat built-in function, you don't need to worry. Concat function automatically handles. Probably you might know, if you try to concatenate any string with a null, it is going to be null. When I say concatenate with plus symbol. But if you use a concat operator, if you use a concat built-in function, you don't need to worry. So let me show you practically that also. First, before going to show you practically that, let me show you the sample data which I am planning to use. Yes, if you see this, I have a employee table which contains 3 records and 5 columns. See, which are having some of the columns are having values, some of the columns are empty if you see here. So in this employee name column, name is null. Mobile column number is null here. And email, this is email is null. So let me apply concat built-in function for the employee table. Select. So I can put star by default, comma, I'm putting again concat of, I'm going to make it as emp name, comma, something email. I'm just trying to concatenate these two from EMP. Okay, so now let me run this. Yeah, one more point let me add alias for this result. Now if I run this, if you observe very closely, okay, so employee name null here and the email ID is null. So I am going to apply concat operator between employee name and email. So if you see here, employee name is this and email is null. But ideally, if you use a plus operator, the result would be empty only. But here, when you use a concat function, so you will be getting the original value. Even if you sum with, even you concatenate with a null or empty, you won't get null as a result. You will get a original value, and that empty null replaced with a single empty. That's the reason I did not get a null as a result here. Even if you come to the third row, employee name is null and email is having some value. So when I apply concat built-in function, I am getting a result like this. So this is how we need to use the concat built-in function in the SQL Server 2016. If you have any questions on the SQL Server or MS BI, Power BI, Azure, please write your question in the YouTube comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. Please subscribe for more technology videos. That's it about concat built-in function. Thank you for watching.